Cypress Hill. Cypress Hill is an American hip-hop group from Southgate, California. Cypress Hill was the first Latino-American hip-hop recording group to have platinum and multi-platinum albums, selling over 20 million albums worldwide. They are considered to be among the main progenitors of West Coast rap and hip-hop in the early 1990s, being critically acclaimed for their first four albums. The band has also advocated for medical and recreational use of cannabis in the United States. Senen Reyes, also known as Sendog, and El Piano Sergio Reyes, also known as Melo Manes, are brothers born in Pinar del Rio, Cuba. In 1971, their family emigrated to the United States from Cuba. They initially lived in Southgate, California. In 1988, the two brothers teamed up with New York City native Lawrence Muggerud, also known as DJ Muggs, previously in a rap group named 7A3, and Louis Freeze, also known as Bireal, to form a hip-hop group named DVX, Devastating Vocal Excellence. The band soon lost Melo Manes to a solo career, and changed their name to Cypress Hill, after a street in Southgate. After recording a demo in 1989, Cypress Hill signed a record deal with Rough House Records. Their self-titled first album was released in August 1991. The lead single was the double A-side The Funky Feel 1, How I Could Just Kill a Man, which received heavy airplay on urban and college radio. The other two singles released from the album were Hand on the Pump and Latin Lingo, the latter of which combine English and Spanish lyrics. The success of these singles led to the album selling 2 million copies in the U.S. alone. Cypress Hill contributed the song Shoot 'Em Up to the soundtrack off the movie Juice. The group made their first appearance at Lollapalooza on the side stage in 1992. Black Sunday, the group's second album, debuted at number one on the Billboard 200 in 1993, recording the highest sound scan for a rap group up until the time. Also, with their debut still in the charts, they became the first rap group to have two albums in the top 10 of the Billboard 200 at the same time. With Insane in the Brain becoming a crossover hit, the album went triple platinum in the U.S. and sold about 3.25 million copies. The band headlined the Soul Assassins tour with House of Pain and Funk Dubious to support, then performed on a college tour with Rage Against the Machine and 7 Year Bitch. In 1993, Cypress Hill also had two tracks on the Judgment Night soundtrack, teaming up with Pearl Jam, without singer Eddie Vedder on the track Real Thing and Sonic Youth on I Love You Mary Jane. The group later played at Woodstock 94, introducing new member Eric Bobo, son of Willie Bobo and formerly a percussionist with the Beastie Boys. Rolling Stone magazine named the group as the best rap group in their music awards voted by critics and readers. Cypress Hill played at Lollapalooza for two successive years, topping the bill in 1995. They also appeared on the Homer Palooza episode of The Simpsons. Prior to Bobo joining the crew, Panchito Ponch Gomez sat in as a percussionist when not acting. Their third album was released in 1995. The album was certified platinum by the RIAA. Cypress Hill also contributed a track I Wanna Get High to the High Times-sponsored Hempelation album to support Normal. Sendog took a break from the band to form a Los Angeles-based rap-rock band, SX10. Meanwhile, in 1996, Cypress Hill appeared on the first Smoke and Grooves tour, featuring Ziggy Marley, The Fugees, Busta Rhymes and A Tribe Called Quest. The band also released a 9-track EP unreleased and revamped with rare mixes. In 1997, band members focused on their solo careers. Muggs released Soul Assassins, Chapter 1 featuring contributions from Dr. Dre, KRS-One, Wyclef Jean, and Mobb Deep. Bireal appeared with Busta Rhymes, Coolio, LL Cool J and Method Man on Hit 'Em High from the multi-platinum Space Jam soundtrack. He also appeared with RBX, Nas and KRS-One on East Coast Killer, West Coast Killer from Dr. Dre's Dr. Dre Presents The Aftermath album, and contributed to an album entitled The Psycho Realm with the band of the same name. Though the focus that year was not on group efforts, the band played Smoke and Grooves with George Clinton and Erykah Badu. Cypress Hill released four in 1998 which went gold in the U.S., on the backs of hit singles Tequila Sunrise and Dr. Green Thumb. Sendog also released the Get Wood sampler as part of SX10 on the label Flip. In 1999, Cypress Hill helped with a PC crime video game. Three of the band's songs from the 1998 4 album were in the game, 16 Men Till There's No Men Left, Checkmate and Lightning Strikes. Bireal also did voice work for some of the game's characters. Also in 1999, the band released a greatest hits album in Spanish, Los Grandes Éxitos en Español. In 2000, Cypress Hill then fused genres with their fifth album, Skull and Bones, which was a two-disc album. The first disc, Skull, was composed of rap tracks while Bones explored further the group's forays into rock. The album reached the top 5 on the Billboard 200 and number 3 in Canada. The first single was Rock Superstar for rock radio and Rap Superstar for urban radio. Following the release of the album, Cypress Hill, along with MXPX, landed a slot opening for The Offspring on the Conspiracy of One tour. The band also released Live at the Fillmore, a concert disc recorded at the Fillmore in San Francisco, in 2000. Cypress Hill continued their experimentation with rock on the Stone Raiders album in 2001. However, its sales were a disappointment, as the disc did not even reach the top 50 of the U.S. album charts. In 2001, the group appeared in the film How High. Cypress Hill recorded Just Another Victim for WWE as a theme song for Taz. At the time, WWE was using original music for almost all of the wrestlers. The band released Till Death Do Us Part on March 23, 2004. The album saw the band experiment with reggae, especially on the lead single What's Your Number. The track features Tim Armstrong of Rancid on guitar and backup vocals. It is based on the classic song The Guns of Brixton on The Clash's London Calling and has proven to be a success on the modern rock charts. However, the album represented a further departure from the signature sound of their first four albums. The album also features appearances by Damian Marley, son of Bob Marley, protege of Mobb Deep and producers The Alchemist and Frederick. In 2004, the song How I Could Just Kill a Man was included in the popular video game created by Rockstar Games, playing on West Coast hip-hop radio station Radio Los Santos. In December 2005, a best-of compilation album titled Greatest Hits from the Bong was released, including 9 hits from previous albums and 2 new tracks. The group's next album was tentatively scheduled for an early 2007 release. In the summer of 2006, Be Real appeared on Snoop Dogg's single Vado, which was produced by Pharrell Williams. In 2007, Cypress Hill toured with their full lineup as a part of the Rock the Bells tour, held by Gorilla Union, B-Sim, and headlined with Public Enemy, Wu-Tang Clan, Nas, and a reunited Rage Against the Machine. On July 25, 2008, Cypress Hill performed at a benefit concert at the House of Blues Chicago, where a majority of the proceeds went to the Chicago Alliance to End Homelessness. In August 2009, a new song by Cypress Hill, titled Get 'Em Up, was made available on iTunes. The song is featured on the Madden NFL 2010 video game. In November 2009, a new version of the Guns N' Roses classic Paradise City performed by Cypress Hill, Slash and Fergie was made available as a bonus track to Slash's single Sahara from Slash's solo album Slash. Cypress Hill's 8th studio album Rise Up features contributions from Everlast, Tom Morello, Darren Malakian, Pitbull, Mark Anthony, and Mike Shinoda. The album was released on Priority Records / Emmy Entertainment, as the group was signed to the label by new creative chairman Snoop Dogg on January 15, 2010. The album was released on April 20, 2010. The album's introduction single, It Ain't Nothin', was released as a free download from the group's official website. The song Rise Up was featured at WWE's pay-per-view, Elimination Chamber, as the official theme song for that event, and was released as the third single for the album, with Armada Latina being fourth. The song also appeared in the trailer of the movie The Green Hornet. Cypress Hill commenced its Rise Up tour in Philadelphia on April 10, 2010. Julio G had replaced DJ Muggs for the tour. Muggs had been absent due to working on several other projects, including separate albums with Be Real and Sendog. The group was supposed to stop in Tucson, Arizona, but canceled the show in protest of the recent immigration legislation. At the Rock and Sane Festival in Paris on August 27, 2010, they said in an interview that they would wait and see what happens with the legislation before going back there. Cypress Hill performed at the Reading and Leeds festivals in 2010, on August 28 at Leeds and August 29 at Reading. On June 5, 2012, Cypress Hill and dubstep artist Rusko released a collaborative EP entitled Cypress X Rusko. Also in 2012, Cypress Hill collaborated with Deadmau5 on his 6th studio album titled Goes Here, lending vocals on Failbait. In August 2017, Cypress Hill's Ain't Going Out Like That was featured as a trailer soundtrack for Netflix's Narcos Season 3. On September 28, 2018, Cypress Hill released the album Elephants on Acid, which saw the return of DJ Muggs as main composer and producer. One of the band's most striking aspects is Burial's exaggeratedly high-pitched nasal vocals. In the book Check the Technique, Burial describes his nasal style, saying his rapping voice is high and annoying. The nasal style I have was just something that I developed. My more natural style wasn't so pleasing to DJ Muggs and Sendog's ears, and talking about the nasal style in the book How to Rap, Burial says, you want to stand out from the others and just be distinct. When you got something that can separate you from everybody else, you gotta use it to your advantage. In the film Art of Rap, Burial credits the Beastie Boys as an influence when developing his rapping style. Sendog's voice is deeper, more violent and often shouted alongside the rapping. His vocals are often emphasized by adding another background/choir voice to say them. Sendog's style is in contrast to Burial's, who says, Sen's voice is so strong, and it all blends together when they are both on the same track. Both Burial and Sendog started writing lyrics in both Spanish and English, and Burial was inspired to start writing raps from watching Sendog and Mellow Man Ace writing their lyrics, and originally Burial was going to just be the writer for the group rather than a rapper. Their lyrics are noted for bringing a cartoonish approach to violence by Peter Shapiro in AllMusic. The sound and groove of their music, produced by Muggs, has spooky sounds and stoned aesthetic, with its bass-heavy rhythms and odd sample loops. Insaneing the Brain has a pitched altered horse neigh looped in its chorus. It carries a psychedelic value, which lessened in the later albums. For using rock/metal instrumentation, the band is sometimes classified as a rap rock/rap metal group. The double album Skull and Bones consists of a pure rap album, Skull, and an entire CD of rap/rock/nu metal songs, Bones. In the live album Live at the Fillmore, some of the old classics are played in a rock/metal version, with Sendog's band SX10 and Eric Bobo playing the rock instrument. While the first album and Black Sunday follow a more minimalistic and funky sound, 3, Temples of Boom, has a very dark, spooky atmosphere and heavy beats, sometimes approaching hardcore rap. 4 introduced more diverse sounds on the beats while maintaining the hardcore edge. The first albums are mostly influenced by psychedelic music, but the band eventually got closer to modern rap as it is today while still experimenting with rock from time to time, like on Skull and Bones and Stone Raiders. Grammy Awards, MTV Video Music Awards. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.